News First, Newsline with Faraz Shaukat Ali.
And a splendid morning it is to you. This is Newsline, live as always from the News First studios in Dorset Street in Colombo. And it's a lovely day out there. No rain, brilliant weather, nice and tropical. And this wonderful morning, we're joined by public interest activist, former chairman of the Bank of Ceylon, Mr. Rusri Pala Tenakorn. Very good morning to you, Mr. Tenakorn.
Good morning, Faraz.
I see Irangani has let you out this morning again. Yes. Long suffering, isn't she? She said, because you're abandoning her every morning at this time. And you're going off and all sorts of public interest matters.
What to do? These are all in our system, no?
In the system.
Yes.
But we are very appreciative of you coming and sharing your analysis on various matters.
Yes.
I thought we'll start the day off with press conference that was held at the Parliament yesterday by the Ministry of Highways in response to a suggestion that His Excellency President Sirisena made earlier last week, actually.
Yeah.
And it was, of course, to do with the Central Expressway.
Yes.
And the matter was, we are saying that there's been a definite departure from process. And it's not between one company or another, although that is also part, a central component of the story. The real story here is an abuse of power. They've departed from national procurement guidelines and trying to bring in various things out of the way, you know. And so we thought we'll play this little clip of what happened yesterday. You can see the way the minister walks away when the question gets tough. Here we go.
We have not granted the tender for the Central Expressway to anyone. Following cabinet approval, the tender is to be given to Taisei Corporation. The decision was taken following a cabinet paper. The Japanese government requested to incorporate Fujita Corporation. The cabinet and the economic subcommittee, which is chaired by the Prime Minister, approved this. The cabinet was chaired by the President. Every time I meet the Mahanayaka Theros, they ask me when will the expressway be completed.
Even though the minister made such a statement to reporters today, on the 15th of May 2017, President Maithripala Sirisena, making observations on the cabinet paper tabled by the Prime Minister, said the proposed process on the matter was in violation of the government's procurement process. The President commented on this at a media briefing recently.
Bring the RDA and the ministry officials together. Invite the media and have a televised debate or an open debate to make this clear. Those who have issues will raise them. If there is an issue, it will be resolved. This is transparency.
There
is a letter from JEPIC calling to involve both these corporations. You must ask him about that. I am commenting on the letter I got. When the Prime Minister visited Japan, the Japanese government made a request from the Prime Minister to involve Fujita Corporation in this project. The Prime Minister gave those instructions to us.
And during the progress meeting, and told the President that I thought a company that had been disqualified by the experts should not be part of a consortium. That is why I told the President that it's not very nice to have a company that was rejected by the experts on the grounds that they didn't have experience, on the grounds that since this road involves a lot of difficult parts, that I felt that it is not the right thing to ask a company that was rejected by the experts.
And after all,
to
you
be part of the consortium.
Japan, Japan.
What do you mean about deals with the bidders? The funds come from Japan. I believe I am a citizen of this country, even though you don't think so. The bid is given to Taisei Corporation after calling for tenders. The money comes from Japan. If we need to give it to Taisei Corporation or Fujita Corporation only, we would not have a need to call for the tenders. Mahinda Rajapaksa was building the Southern Expressway.
Please let me.
When Mahinda Rajapaksa wanted to give it to one person, he did not consult anyone. He presented the paper to cabinet and granted it. It refers to the Southern Expressway and the Katunayake Expressway.
And that was the minister's response. He's walking away. Mr. Rajapaksa, there are significant lies that have been told there. The minister lies when he says that this money has been given by the Japanese government. It's not being given by the Japanese government. It is being given by a Japanese bank. And there's insurance, a supplier credit insurance, Nexi Insurance is there at a very high premium, 10.07% in advance. The Prime Minister signs that off, actually, not Mr. Kiriala. But Mr. Kiriala is absolutely misleading the public. He's misleading everybody, whether it is by design or by omission, I don't know. But what he says is absolute lies. I'm sorry to start the day this morning off making such a statement, but it's a matter of fact.
Yeah.
Mr. Kiriala continues to maintain this lie that the Japanese government are insisting on bringing in some bidder, when in fact the official position of the Japanese government has been communicated through a letter sent by the Japanese ambassador to our Prime Minister, in which they say that Japan respects the legal and lawful tender processes of our government, and including the Central Expressway Section 3. What do you have to say? You must have followed this.
Yeah. For us, I'm afraid this is a matter we have to be a bit too hard and express our views very candidly, because the way that this minister is replying the media to elicit doubts that have been created about this transaction at the instigation of the president of the country, you know, is in no way can be condoned, because the way he behaved is, I should say, the least, is disgraceful.
Let me
comment on point four.
Yes, yeah.
Now, he's trying to, it is like, it looks as, appears as if, you know, he's like a child punished by a school principal, undergoing the punishment, trying to do that unwillingly. This is not something that the president wanted the minister to come and do unwillingly and run away from the journalist.
It's not some teledrama.
He wanted, in a very serious manner, giving the due respect to the media, giving the due respect to the public concerns that have been expressed, to throw light on this matter which has been discussed widely. Mm. What did the minister do instead? It is the way he handled this issue. He is bringing Mahinda Rajapaksa. Who is worried about what Mahinda
exactly.
Rajapaksa?
Exactly. The minute they bring Mahinda Rajapaksa into it, you know that they're covering something.
No.
Up.
Who was?
It's the same with the bond. Remember?
No. Now, President, when he said that he go and explain this before to the public, with the answering the questions raised by the media, which they are very legitimately, correctly, with a whole lot of information that they have collected on their own, have raised this issue. Now you're talking about the Mahinda Rajapaksa. Is this country worried about that situation?
Exactly.
Has this government been elected to repeat what Mahinda Rajapaksa did? Or to keep on criticizing about it? Now see, his idea to bring in the high priest of this country, the Mahanayaka Theros, into the highways thing.
Yeah.
Now, this is a joke, though, Faraz. I mean, it is disgraceful in that sense for him to even mention their names. I mean, I have not heard any public statement being made by the respected Mahanayaka Theros in this country about road constructions. The most I heard about from them was, the country should give priority to the needs of the people and lay aside the other less important
perhaps,
things.
Perhaps Mr. Kiriala, who's an attorney at law and understands very much, presumably, what ultra vires means, right? He has acted over and above his remit, right? He's broken the rules, and on top of all that, when he's clutching at straws, when the minute he starts quoting about Mahinda Rajapaksa, doesn't he realize that he is having this job because the people didn't want to carry on with what was supposed to have been done under the Rajapaksa?
But as the subject is very clear, if he simply resorted to explain to whom the contract was awarded, how it was awarded, and how it is funded. Now, on all these three counts, now here is a minister who comes and gives as an explanation that the Prime Minister spoke for half an hour in the Parliament. Who cares?
He can even speak for 3 hours for all I care.
I'm asking you, is it relevant for us?
And the other thing, what he's trying to mask by his action, walking away, that's an absolute insult. It's like inviting some people to your house and then you just walk away, leaving them to fend for themselves in your house.
Let me suffice by confining myself comment to this one. His walking away shows, one, he has not complied with what the president wanted. Two, he is running away from the problem. Three, he is leaving the crisis as it is without giving any, throwing any light on the matter.
Why did the one of the questions was yesterday that the journalists were asking was why it is, on what mandate, what is the basis that the minister is holding, having a meeting with bidders, with the two bidders, Taisei Fujita, and in between all this there are two other companies, Punji Lloyd, which is an Indian company, and another company, some Mercator Relocations. It's a relocation company according to their website.
Yes.
I of course fail to see why you need a relocation company to build a road.
Yeah.
However, the presence of Punji Lloyd, to begin with, this meeting is absolutely illegal and out of order because the minister has no right to negotiate with bidders. That's why we have a cabinet appointed negotiating committee.
Yeah. The worst situation is he's trying to avoid all those important issues and also in the process tell a very big lie that the government of Japan is involved in this transaction. I mean, to the best of our knowledge, with the information that have been released very legitimately and in an acceptable form by the journalist who found this information, I mean, we have not seen a bit of evidence to prove that the government of Japan, per se the government, is not involved in this matter. What the government apparently has said is, I mean, they have said, we respect the tender procedures of the government of Sri Lanka. Does it mean that the government of Japan is interested in the particular awarding of the tender? I mean, it is absolute rubbish, I should say.
Complete utter tosh. And, you know, basically, as one of our viewers has just sent a message, says, if the Japanese government want to suggest contractors, then they must fund the project.
Exactly.
The Tokyo Mitsubishi Bank is not the government of Japan. This is a commercial transaction.
Exactly, Farah. This is a commercial loan. Any other bank with this type of security, sovereign coverage, would have come into this with the rates of interest that is being given.
And the president mentioned that progress meeting.
Yes.
He said, yes, but that may be so, but it is the people of our country who have to pay it back.
Exactly.
And as reported by Saman Indrajit in the island this morning, he's quoting what Minister Kiriala said yesterday, that the government is to award the third stage of the Central Expressway next week, in spite of the controversy. This shows a complete and blatant disregard to public concern.
Unfortunate repetition of what exactly happened in the bond case for us. In the parliament, when this matter was raised first, if due action was taken at the appropriate time, the country would have been saved with a lot of, in the first place, our good name in the economic field would have been saved. It would have saved billions of monies costing to the public of this country. All that did not happen due to the obstinacy displayed by some people who are in responsible places. Same thing is happening today. When the president of the country says, go and explain it to the public before you take a decision, he walks away saying that we are doing it in 3 months. What does it mean for us? Yeah. Is there a government within a government? Is there a separate force in operation?
You know, these people must realize that they are in power largely in thanks to the fact that President Sirisena won the mandate of the people. And they seem to have conveniently forgotten this. And yeah. They're just acting willy-nilly. This is not, I have to say this again and again, this is not the personal property of Ranil Wickremesinghe, Laxman Kiriala, Manik Samaravikrama, or any other person there. This is the people's monies we're talking about, the people of this country. Your money. You must raise the issues. Don't let it get away.
Faraz, I didn't wind up this issue.
Yes.
I think I should say that this is a time that the media institutions of this country should give the perfect backing to the president more than at any other time. If he is interested in listening to the public and then seeing that justice is done, correct things are done, and if that is his intention, the media must serve that purpose by continuing to do these exposures and then bring things to light for the best knowledge of the public.
You bet your bottom dollar, the media ain't going to stop. Yes. We are not going to stop. Several comments, and if you do want to send it in, it's 0772-300-305. One of those comments here, and I think the number will come up on a card, but one of these comments, only those who have vehicles and money to pay the toll can use an expressway, but everyone pays the cost, whereas masses use the railways. Why not develop the railways? The difference between inclusive versus exclusive development. And another one here. I continue to confirm your position regarding this minister who has been intolerable. He is trying to shield the Prime Minister too. Why is he running away from questions? Will your comments be going to the bin? Well, I hope not. And somebody else says here, good morning. What you are witnessing is the downturn of the UNP once again because of cursed ministers like this. I will never vote for them again. And he says, you can mention my name. It's Channa. One person can make a difference. And there you go. Remember that. One person can make a difference when you're casting your vote. Here goes another message. Whatever said and done, MR has done something. There are two or three highways. This government can't do a robbery, at least in a proper way. So inefficient. Well, apart from being inefficient, they're absolute lying. They're lying. The minister is lying. He's lying when he says this. If he was, what we're saying is wrong and what he's saying is actually correct, he should have sat there, he should have had all the documentation, and he should have paraded it in a flourish to everybody to see. When he can't do that, or he won't do that, the question arises, what is the minister masking? Well, you know, it's an absolutely intolerable position. And we hope that... do you think that the president should have a commission?
No, in this case, I'm sure the president will not permit this to go on in this form, because it is so apparent, so open, so clear that there is something fishy happening in this.
Very fishy. Now then, let's move on, as the Shamir Rasuldeen will say. Let's move on. Let's move on to this next cut here. It's another matter. Back to Bondgate and the proceedings yesterday when the Presidential Commission of Inquiry into the Issuance of Bonds issued a special statement, and they addressed the issue of Mr. Mahendran being a Singaporean national. they seem to, his lawyer seems to have forgotten that he was also the governor of the central bank, in spite of. And so here we go. Let's listen to this special segment on the bond.
The Presidential Commission states Arjuna Mahendran, being a foreign citizen, does not take him outside the jurisdiction, and he had to obey the summons. Especially after accepting appointment as governor of the Central Bank of Sri Lanka, Mahendran cannot claim that he is outside our law. It notes Mahendran is in a very different position to Arjun Aloysius. Arjun Aloysius appeared in response to summons and pleaded that he is likely to be the accused in a criminal case in the High Court. If he is compelled to give evidence, he may incriminate himself. The Commission says Arjun Aloysius invoked the golden rule of the law that an accused cannot be forced to incriminate himself. The Presidential Commission states it is obliged to keep within the intent and spirit of the law. It adds compelling Arjun Aloysius to give evidence would have resulted in an application to the Superior Court for judicial review. This may have resulted in much delay in conducting these proceedings. The Commission says compelling Aloysius to give evidence against his wishes may have raised a potential question of law, that being the admissibility of the entirety of the evidence that emerges from these proceedings. The statement says Arjuna Mahendran does not invoke any right of an accused or likely accused and is compelled to give evidence. The Commission does not think Arjuna Mahendran is foolish as to not take the opportunity to give evidence and his explanation.
There you are, Mr. Rajapala.
Yes.
You, what's your take?
Yes. Now, this is very clear. Arjuna Mahendran obviously did not take the cover that Arjuna Aloysius took in this case for not coming to give evidence, because Arjuna Aloysius took up the position that he will incriminate himself if he, there's a possibility, if he comes and gives evidence. Now here he is trying to take cover for being a foreigner,
so
for
what?
Being a non-citizen. Now Faraz, the basic question we are going to ask now is, what we have been raising all throughout in this issue, who appointed this foreigner? When such a position becomes vulnerable to come before the public and give statements under the laws of this country, here we have a person who can take cover under the position saying that I am not a citizen. Now, who is the person who appointed such a person to such an important position in this country?
Ranil Wickremesinghe.
My God, he is answerable to this to the last. If Arjuna Mahendran takes up the position, he being a foreigner, he is not coming to give evidence, entire responsibility of that statement goes to the Prime Minister.
And you know, it's absolutely astonishing. I wonder whether he thought the same way while he was high spending using his central bank credit card, when he bought Pampers and he bought jewelry and he went on a spending spree. By the way, the governor of the central bank's credit card carries with it an unlimited entertainment allowance. Did he think about all that when he was doing that and enjoying the high life? Did he? Why doesn't he come to this program and explain himself instead of being so mummified?
Faraz, you know, it is very unfortunate that the whole world is laughing at us on issues like this. Here is the top ranking banker in this country who is the custodian of the funds belonging to the bank, the government, taking up the position. I cannot give, who is ready to take up the position if it becomes necessary, that I am a foreigner, therefore I am not bound to give evidence. I mean, the whole country would be looking at us. What is our stability? What is our acceptability in the economic field in this country? And furthermore, now this Mahendran now is giving evidence as if, you know, he has come to accept this position to relieve the country from a turmoil that was there at that time.
He was doing us a favor.
My God, yes. He says that it appears to somebody that there was no central bank, there was no rule of law, there was no system in that to the economics of the, there was no method to the madness in the short place,
yeah.
in very short terms.
Yeah.
By the time he accepted the position as the governor of the central bank, my God, do you want us to believe this?
It's absolute rubbish. It's absolute rubbish. And Mr. Mahendran, you know, one of our viewers, several of them actually, have raised this matter over the last few weeks.
Yeah.
And that is, why can't travel restrictions be placed on him? Surely, the foreigners in this country are not above the law.
So far as one thing is certain, that he won't run away from this position because it is going to bring implications to others.
UNP or to the Mr. Wickremesinghe?
To the UNP and to the people who appointed him, all those will be very badly implicated.
Can I interpret something?
Yes.
When Mr. Rishipala says those who appointed him, I can let you on a secret. It's Mr. Wickremesinghe who appointed him.
And I must say one more thing. In with great respect, the commission is playing very safe in this matter. They do not want to leave room for the people who are interested and who are behind the back operators to delay this matter any further by taking the matter before appeal courts and so on. In the event the commission forcibly violate rules by eliciting evidence against the laws.
Thank you. There's a message that I'm going to read out. It's just come in. It says, Mr. Faraz, I have been watching Newsline for the past 1 year, and my conclusion is that you are biased. Oh, really? I'd like to ask you what I'm biased about, because we have exposed and continue to highlight, not only exclusively, but we have taken on the courageous reporting of all journalists, where the public interest matters. If the media did not highlight this position, I assure you that Arjuna Mahendran will not be in House Dorf yesterday. He would have been sitting inside the Central Bank of Sri Lanka, and you and me and Mr. Rishipala and everybody else in this country would have not been privy to the absolute treachery that was going on at the Central Bank.
I won't get offended with that comment, Faraz. Yes, we are biased. Why? Because of the facts. Factually, what we are aware and what is before us makes us to be biased strongly against Arjuna Mahendran and his operations.
Absolutely.
We don't take cover under anything else. He is, as far as we are concerned, with the facts available, with the facts elicited, with the evidence that has come out, there is no reason for anyone not to be biased against him.
Whilst the President is facing the world at the United Nations Assembly and putting in Sri Lanka's stock and trying to get Sri Lanka's stock up, the Minister of Highways is not only undermining the President but disgracefully lying. This exposing and this continuously reporting the truth to the public is not the preserve of our group. We, along with the other media, are striving to report the truth so that the public can know what on earth is happening. I'd just like to put that on record. Mr. Rishipala, you know, it's always a pleasure to have you on the program. Do you think that today will be a difficult day at the Presidential Commission of Inquiry?
I believe that the cross-examination will commence. And if it commences, there are many, very many areas that will be corrected by the Attorney General's Department officials, because the leading of evidence all this time, you know, made it appear that, you know, Arjuna Mahendran is, you know, like, he's not responsible, he does not know anything, he's not second to RK.
Oh, yes.
Not knowing certain things that happened under his nose.
Yeah.
In the same manner, Arjuna Mahendran also did not know certain things that were happening. It looks like.
Do you know, we were at the commission the other day,
yes.
and we heard him say this. And he said that although they lived in the same house in Flower Road, they never discussed anything to do with work, as in, and tell us, Mr. Rissipala.
Yeah.
So he never did, but he gave the game away. You tell the story.
Yes. The answer is very clear for us. On the 16th of January 2015, his son-in-law Arjuna Aloysius resigns from the directorate of his company PTL, the primary dealer, on the grounds that it is going to create a conflict of interest when his father-in-law Arjuna Mahendran is going to be appointed on the 23rd of January 2015. Now they have not had any discussions. They want this country to believe all this nonsense.
Well, it's just like the other minister who was working like a dog from 7 to 11, and he forgot they didn't discuss this matter of a 165 million rupee apartment in a part of Colombo.
I pity the lawyers who give them such instructions.
Well, I trust the fees are appropriately high. The final question final answer or response to the people who say that I am biased. Well, let me say that we are with no parties. We are with the people. We have demonstrated this in several ways. On that note, I think it's time to hand it all back to MCR in De Palma. And Mr. Rissipala Thinakul, thank you very much. I hope that we'll see you in the courthouse today later on.
Yeah. Pleasure being here, Paras.
Thank you. And that's it from Newsline. We'll see you again, same time, same place, tomorrow morning. Take care. God bless.
News First, Newsline with Faraz Shaukat Ali.